Change. That's a commission. That's something that the governor set up just before. He off
bump. So why yell at them?
No, I'm not yelling at you. You're missing the point. I'm not yelling at you. I'm sick of BS commission on the way they got it set up. So whether it's they can do something or not, they got paper to go back and write to the governor, speak to the governor, whoever, or the president, whoever.
So?
Whoever,
sorry,
according
man.
To the governor.
Oh.
They
say
they
got
to, you know. So they say, we're going to go into these little groups and get rid of everybody. No, keep it focused, man. Keep it whole. Keep it focused.
If that's the case, everybody want to vent and talk about what happened, how they feel.
I don't want to vent about what happened. I want them to start making things change. Election coming up, far as with purposes, we know purpose is going to change because election's coming up in April. And we're going to change purposes. You can bank on that. Purpose is going to get changed. We're going to change purposes in April. And that's not another thing. I don't hear nobody talking about that. And because that's major. Vote. That's how you make change. That's how you make change through voting. You know, I ain't really heard. I said that at the last meeting about that.
You know it's called the first commission.
I know exactly. I feel you, bro.
In Ferguson, because all these issues don't just.
I know, but that's what. But we wouldn't have none of this. We wouldn't have none of this if it wouldn't have been for Ferguson. And so they gave the name Ferguson for a reason. It got the Ferguson Commission name for a reason. For a reason. That's right. I got young sons. My son, 21, 25. They live out. They live in Ferguson right now. They know what. They know what time it is. We've been out there for years, man. We've been out there for years, all over. That's right. I listen to the young people. I listen to the young people.
You know what?
I listen to the young people.
You're not though.
And I'm saying, we are not.
Right. I'm not worried about that, about discrepancy, because that's what they like. They want, as long as they can hear one or two discrepancy among them, they're going to take this right here. They'll take this right here. You'll hear this on the TV, but you won't hear the other side, because that's what they look. They like something exciting. TV looks like stuff exciting. That's what it's all to be about. You have town hall meetings. When you have town hall meetings both consist of people talking all day, you know, the people, not those people that they got sitting up there all day, dog. All day, you know what I'm saying? So I'm not worried about that, you know. I've been out there. They just getting out here. I've been out through the struggle many years. So they can take their advice and listen. I'm an open line. I listen. But at the same time, when I want to get heard, I talk loud, and I'm going to be heard. When I want to get heard, I'm going to make sure I get heard. I be heard, plain and simple, just like they're going to be heard. But don't always somebody say, I'm going to give you 1 minute to talk, and then you take up the other 25 minutes to hold up to something nobody that's going to make everybody fall asleep about. If you want to hear something, you want to hear the truth, like I said, go out here, get the real people. You want a commission, get people that's really out there. You want to hear what's going on for real about black people, about their struggle, or the inequities, or the inequities that's going on and so forth, bro. You go out there, you go to the real people, man, and quit getting these select people that you want to rep, talk about they rep. The views of those people do not represent the views of the real struggling black people. Real talk, bro. And that's how I feel on that. Like I said, you know, when I come to these meetings, they want us to come, they want us to be part of these meetings and voice our displeasure or our concerns or whatever. That's what we have
with
to do,
that,
but you got to give us a platform.
We got to figure out how we're going to get that solution as well. So we're getting it, you know, we're getting the concerns out, but how we going to work together to get to the solution?
Well, how we work together is that if you start really listening to the concerns of other people for real and just quit making up these things. You know, it ain't going to never get nowhere. It's going to keep on dragging just like this. It's going to keep on. Man, it started in 68. Look where we at now. We still at the... So ask ourselves. That's why I'm... Y'all young, bro. Ask ourselves. Where have we... Ask yourself from 68 to 2014. What goals have we achieved out of all this, for real?
That's so sad.
They don't know.
They don't know.
They
got their goals, so they don't know.
But being able to go to school with the car case.
Y'all don't really know the struggle, and I'm trying to help.
So all I'm saying is,
but where we at now, we at,
you cannot allow your perspective, because you're an older man, overshadow our perspective as a younger generation. You can't do that.
What you mean, overshadow how?
We hear you all, and not over talk.
That is the conversation you guys.